essence of Bonner. Purity, integrity, loyalty. Founded by the Augustinians in 1953, we had an initial identity crisis until being named after a former superintendent of schools, Monsignor John Bonner. Monsignor Bonner High School is a very special place. For over 50 years, roughly 18,000 young men started each day by entering these doors, following the directions of the Augustinians, who have devoted their lives to molding these boys to men. Their influence was, and still is, reflected in all facets of students' life: social, athletic, intellectual, and spiritual growth. Bonner really is a special place. In September of 2002, Father Gus Esposito celebrated an opening day mass marking the beginning of the 50th anniversary of Monsignor Bonner High School. To officially start the celebration, a banner was unfurled from the stage, then placed outside the school for all to see. The celebration continued on September 29th with a communion breakfast and mass, attended by over 400 graduates and students. Colonel Thomas Matthews, Monsignor Bonner 1967, was the keynote speaker. Colonel Matthews spoke about the real-life experiences in war and the making of the movie Black Hawk Down. He stressed that the tools that soldiers carry into battle in their kit box are the same tools for life acquired at Monsignor Bonner High School: respect, loyalty, honor, and obedience. In February of this year, over 700 people attended the Monsignor Bonner High School Hall of Fame dinner at Drexelbrook.
John DiStilio and every other kid who went through Bonner High School, who bring it to the table every day for their family, for their church, and for this school. It's my honor to accept this award.
18 outstanding members of the Bonner community were inducted at this time, from doctors to judges, faculty, coaches, and clergy to Olympic athletes, some leaders of business and leaders of the community, and even a TV anchorman, all champions in their own ways, all worthy contributors to the history and tradition of Monsignor Bonner High School. And all of these Hall of Famers knew the value of Bonner's mission statement: to educate young men in the Catholic and Augustinian tradition, with emphasis on their spiritual, intellectual, athletic, and social development.
The senior retreat has a big impact on the school because it brings the senior class together and learn to appreciate people a little more.
The Rosary rallies. Amazing, you get 1,000 kids in the courtyard, and behavior is so great, and the kids really get into it.
I remember the class masses at Bonner.
I think I coach here a lot because of my spirituality, with the fact that you just to give back to the kids.
A senior retreat. Bring mass, probably.
A daily communion service.
The Rosary rally.
I guess one of the most important experiences for any Bonner senior has been senior retreat. And it will continue to hold a very important place in my life.
I would have to say the senior retreat.
Spiritually, it would have to be the senior retreat.
I believe the senior retreat.
The homecoming mass.
I think their approach to the liturgies is exceptional, and the cross service.
The cross service for Easter is great. I get to confession more often than I would.
I'd have to say the cross service.
The Rosary rally or the cross service at Easter?
Between the Rosary rally and the cross service.
The cross service at Easter. And I think it's a very moving experience, and I think the boys don't know what to expect if they're a freshman the first time through, and it's a pretty powerful scene. It really is.
I think the religious values that come across in almost every classroom provide Bonner students with the opportunity not only to know their God, but to experience their God in so many real forms.
I think that Bonner, you know, helps you become a well-rounded individual, whatever your endeavor, whether it be, educationally, athletically, socially. I think that I was extremely well-prepared when graduating Bonner.
I left Bonner, went on to the University of Pennsylvania. A lot of my classmates there were from different private schools, you know, across the country. And I felt I had every bit of the education that a lot of them had.
A lot of things that I learned at Bonner were, from an educational standpoint, I used immediately.
I think the educational experience here was very powerful.
I think Bonner offers students a well-rounded education academically.
My favorite faculty member.
My favorite teacher in Bonner.
Ralph Saladonio.
Father John Denny, of course, is the kids just revered him. I mean, they would follow him anywhere.
Probably Mr. Saboji. He's very funny. He tells some great stories.
My favorite teachers were, of course, everybody's favorite, Ralph Saladonio and Vince Donahue.
I'd have to say that's a toss-up between Charles McLaughlin, Scum, and Alex McGrath, my biology teacher.
Father Murnane for Latin and Father Ferentz for chemistry.
Mr. Collier.
Father Milton, he was by far a role model.
Favorite faculty member had to be Father Horn.
Father Casey. He taught religion in a very indirect way.
My junior, senior year, I remember having some exceptionally fine teachers. Father McCluskey for history, Mr. Brown for English.
I'd have to say Father Atkinson, only because every time you see him, he's so happy. And with a person in that difficult of a situation, you'd think that maybe his morale would be brought down. But every time you ask him how he's doing, he's always happy. And he's just glad to be alive and be here. And waking up every morning, something he enjoys coming over here.
Father Atkinson, definitely.
Mr. Donahue, definitely. I had a lot of great teachers, Mr. Watson, Mr. Saladonio, Mr. Skronsky, but Mr. Donahue, I think.
Father William Ricuti.
Freshman year. First period, Father Dan Menahan, Old Testament. He was the toughest teacher I had at Bonner.
Definitely Mr. Watson, U.S. Honors History. Tough guy, but good guy.
Mr. Student.
Jim McGrath, as a teacher in a classroom, wow, it was really impressive.
James McGrath's English class our junior year. He put forth a guideline for us to be free thinkers.
AP European History with Mr. Skronsky, sophomore year. That was insane. That was really hard.
I look back on my days at Bonner, and certainly the academics were important, and we gained a lot through that. But also the athletic environment was fantastic. Some of the greats that came out of there with Frankie Corus and John Cappelletti.
I remember watching John Cappelletti try to quarterback the Bonner team against Cardinal Dougherty for the Catholic League Championship in a cold December day.
Cappelletti was a sophomore when I was a senior. Well, he wasn't a future Heisman Trophy winner then. He was just a nice kid. He was somebody that had a future. You could tell that even at that early age as a sophomore.
Joe, the youngest member of my family, Joseph, is very ill. He has leukemia. And if I could dedicate this trophy to him tonight and give him a couple days of happiness, this is worth everything.
You don't need a blessing. God has already blessed you in John Cappelletti. God love you.
One of the greatest series of plays that I can remember, and it involved a guy named Ed Coyle, who most Bonner alumnus they know, he's in the Hall of Fame and everything. But at the time, he was the manager of the football team, and most people know that he was afflicted with polio and at a young age, and he wasn't allowed to play. But this one day, this one game, Jack Godchalk taped up his brace, and for three plays, he was allowed to play football. And it was a most amazing thing I ever saw. He, out of the three plays, he made two tackles at middle linebacker. And everybody's eyes welled up. And at that age, you weren't really sure whether you were supposed to cry or not. But I looked over at my coach, and he was crying. So I guess it's good everybody was crying. And that's what I remember. And I've repeated that story many, many times when they've asked me what the greatest moment in football was. That was it.
What I can remember the most is the football season of my senior year when we won the Catholic League Championship. And every Sunday was an event.
But I think the team aspect of things is probably what I walked away with.
We knew we could do it. We knew we could do it. And these guys knew we could do it. And we did it. Number one, baby. Yeah.
Coming back.
And there's a shot to left field. This one is way back, and this one is gone.
Monsignor Bonner is the 1989 Catholic League champion.
60s, the big rival naturally was West Catholic. As Cardinal O'Hara opened, it changed. It became Cardinal O'Hara. And now, for one reason or another, it's become St. Joe's Prep.
In the 70s, would have been O'Hara.
Has to be St. Joe's Prep.
It used to be O'Hara, but now it's the Prep.
O'Hara.
But when I was here, it was more of the West Catholic.
It was O'Hara when I was here, but it seems to be the Prep now.
The Prep.
No, Cardinal O'Hara.
In my generation, it was West Catholic.
Prep.
The Prep, St. Prep.
With West Catholic.
St. Joe's Prep.
That was West Catholic.
It's West Catholic.
West Catholic.
It's definitely Cardinal O'Hara.
West Catholic. Right now, St. Joe's Prep.
Involved in the ADL, it's the Anti-Defamation League, and it just kind of teaches you to diversify the school and appreciate everybody, even though everyone is different.
Got involved with the Community Service Corps. When I was here, we would go into the inner city and teach kids.
We used to have these great Bonner mixers after basketball games.
There was always the Bonner mixers.
The mixers are always fun.
I remember the gym floor on Heat Wave resonating almost to the point where I thought, if you know, I hope this is engineered right, because if it isn't, we're going down.
They were always a highlight.
Whenever I'm with him, something inside starts to burn in, and I feel this desire.
Definitely the place. I've done 8 plays at between Bonner and Prendy. I've met my best friends, and I just had the time of my life.
Well, Sound of Music was our first production that I was involved in. That was the 79-80 school year. So we've done a whole variety of shows. And you. Place are, you know, seeing the boys finally getting the knack of how to do things and just having fun.
First day at Bonner, September 1967, one of about 700 boys sitting in the auditorium. Father Sevick, who eventually became the principal of Bonner, all 5'2" of him, is on the stage, and he's talking to us, and hears a disturbance, and he asks a certain individual to admit his participation in that disturbance, and Bob Spellman, who I did not know but was from St. Andrew's Parish, volunteered to Father Sevick that he was responsible for the disturbance. He was called to the stage. Bob Spellman was about 6'2". Father Sevick proceeded to physically teach him how to apologize to his classmates, and when he didn't apologize correctly, he got some more physical instruction from Father Sevick. The message was sent loud and clear that when you were sitting in the auditorium and you're told to be quiet, they were serious about that here at Bonner. Bob Spellman still remembers that story, as does every member of the class of 1971.
Greatest myth or legend? That we have a pool on the fourth floor.
That Sister Mary Library wasn't a nice lady. She was beautiful.
The fourth floor pool.
Melton's maidens.
So Mr. Bell comes in, there's 8 guys holding the wall. Mr. Bell, the wall's falling down. Mr. Bell, the wall's falling down. He goes running out of the room. He goes and gets help. By the time he comes back, Everybody's sitting in their desk, doing their homework, like nothing ever happened.
Where is the fourth floor swimming pool?
The fourth floor pool.
Fourth floor pool.
I would say the swimming pool on the fourth floor.
Well, one of the funniest stories that I remember may not have been funny at the time to those involved, but it certainly was funny to me, was when I ruined the gym floor and almost crippled the entire basketball team. It was very dirty and dusty. So I thought to myself, well, if a floor is dirty and dusty, like a coffee table, I would just take a rag and some Pledge and clean it. Well, little did I know that whatever is in end dust and whatever is on a gym floor created a reaction that made the floor like a skating rink. They arrived the next morning for practice. Needless to say, they couldn't practice, nor could they play basketball on the floor, nor could they do anything until the floor was refinished. I think Mr. Bob Vent might recall that very incident, since he had to find me somewhere in the country to ask what I had done to the gym floor.
Best kept secret of Bonner.
Conversation goes a long way with the cafeteria ladies. You can't beat getting the extra couple donuts for the 20 cents, eat a free boat of fries on Friday when you're running a little short. That was good. You got to know how to talk them up.
Well, if you recall the wooden skids that lined the path from Garrett Road up through under the trestle into the parking lot, they at one time were a decoration for our soft hop dance, and they had been procured without payment from all around various food stores and building supply stores in Delaware County on nightly raids by the members of the sophomore class to contribute to this shipbuilding project in the gymnasium.
When we were Prendergast, we used to jump out the windows during jug.
The way they cooked the cafeteria food.
Best kept secret.
Never ran, I don't know. It's a best kept secret.
The best kept secret.
Best kept secret of Bonner.
You don't really understand what it is. And then you start to realize that you can't eat anything in Bonner without the cheese after a while.
The cafeteria line at Bonner, and I had a good friend, you know, when he passed by the mustard in the cafeteria line, he always had the comment that he wanted a nice hot dog, some mustard, and a good stomach pump.
the ketchup jar.
The guy in front of me, you know, spit into the mustard.
Don't use the mustard.
The best kept secret of Bonner is
that the Prendy girls lacked a locker room, and from this side of the building, at the right time of day, at the right angle, you could look over to Prendy's gym and watch them basically change in the windows into their gym uniforms. And it took a lot of phys ed to then counteract the effect of that whole experience. Gym.
Community maybe might be the word.
Bonner is a special place.
Special.
A very special place.
Special.
Tradition.
Family, definitely.
Friendship.
Bonner is special.
My family.
Bonner is special.
Enthusiastic.
Bonner's special. Very special. One comes to mind. Because everybody's, it's like a brotherhood, if you will.
Special.
Bonner's special. In lots of ways.
Dedicated.
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 Special.
Special.
It's fulfilling.
Special.
Proud.
Special.
Energized.
Special.
Special. Enthusiastic.
Monsignor Bonner is a very special place.
Special.
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 Commitment.
Special. Special.
There was a certain aura about this school.
Bonner's a special place.
Respect.
Special.
Special.
Just unique.
Unique.
Bonner's just a unique place altogether.
Special.
Bonner's been a very special place.
Special.
They're proud to wear their sweaters.
Special.
I think the word tradition really comes to mind with Bonner.
Special.
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 Bonner's an Augustinian school, and I hope it stays that. But what makes Bonner great is its alumni.
and they need to understand that. God bless you, Bonner.
When I saw gold and diamond rings, my own drug to ease the pain that living brings, I walked from the mountain to the valley floor, searching for my beautiful reward. Searching for my beautiful reward from a house on the hill, a sacred light shine. I walk through these rooms, none of them are mine. Down empty hallways, I went from door. Searching for my beautiful reward. Searching for my beautiful reward.
But I think Bonner offers opportunity to young people, to parents who are looking for Christ-centered, valued-centered education. So I think Bonner is going to be a commodity that is always in demand.